From the perspective of the neighborhoods that I represent, racial equity work is needed in every corner of our city, and how we do that looks a lot different across our city, right? Which is part of the value of asking neighborhood associations to be part of it because of their reach, right? But my question is, did Cura look at what minimum funding would be necessary for any neighborhood to do race equity work in addition to the work that they're doing today, or was that out of scope?
So from the perspective of the steering committee, that was out of scope. We're proposed to look at a budget neutral amendment, and frankly it would be beyond budget neutral if you wanted to have both of these things together.
If we wanted to have functional neighborhood organizations,
well, if you
and
want,
be able to do race
right,
equity work.
Yeah, and I think there's a couple questions that I would have about that. So one of the things that has really come out of this process is that neighborhood associations view themselves as independent organizations. So part of the question is it the city's responsibility to fund all of the work of neighborhood associations, or is it just the racial equity work? At least for me, I haven't heard like a clear, this is what we want you to analyze. But that would be my first question. And then, yeah, I think there's a lot of sort of deeper analysis. It would be more money than what's currently in the pot, I know that for sure, in order for all 70 neighborhood associations to do racial equity work.